cool photo, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
that?
It would, yeah. Just like it. Just one night, I ain't got time for you, baby. Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby. Right here, right now is all we've got. A little party never killed nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop.
Cole likes to call it a tactical chunder, but in reality, he's just a lightweight. On to the next one. Cole likes to think he's good at football when really a 40-year-old centre-back kicks him out of the team. Which leads us on to our next fact, that he makes a great spectator for his Sunday league team. According to Tom, spectators make a lot of money, so it's all good, mate, don't worry about it.
Cole's music taste is very questionable. If any of you spin the Cole of Cole, it feels like you're in 2009. I'm getting about with Cole out here quite bad. He once lasted 10 seconds with a girl. Wait. Shot, she ain't here tonight.
Very good boy. He gets him a bath when he's told. Cole loves a bath time, didn't you, lad?
One thing you may not know about Cole is he uses insoles in his shoes. He might have told you he's 6'7", but in reality, me and Luke have both measured him and he's 6'5".
Cole walks like a giraffe in roller skates, it's pretty simple. He also loves the massage, so if any of you girls are getting this good box, then you know how to do it.
I love giving massages.
Cole's first lad's holiday, he only went out once, and he managed to complete a full game of Pokemon. It's poor from you, man. Cole's favourite artist is Adele. It speaks for itself.
Cole once told me that he's... Quiet please, come on. Cole sleeps with a fan on every single day of the year. That maybe explains why he's got a red nose all year round.
He might have told you, a few of you guys, that he calls himself DJ Carlos. But in reality, he's never DJed in his life.
And my man has got no rhythm. Have you seen him fucking dance?
If you take a quick close look at Cole, it took him a couple months to grow those couple of chin hairs on his chin. He's got a whole wardrobe designated to Hollister clothing. No offence to you if you wear Hollister, but Cole.
He's got a wall full of pictures, right, at his dad that he refers to, which you probably won't like this. The wall of laughter, love and life. Consider yourself lucky if you get on it anyway.
Cole's probably told you this a few times, but he's got an annex, just in case you guys didn't know.
And it is a fact that we struggled to gather facts tonight for Cole. That was obviously family, you know, relevant. So much so that we had to ask Cole's family for help. But the only fact that they gave us is Cole's not funny and he's boring.
Right, I'm going to make Cole out a fair bit here. So one of Cole's guilty pleasures is that he likes to cook naked in his kitchen. Any of you have had a meal round Cole's and you've found a hair, I don't know what to say to you.
So with the facts over and done with, all jokes aside, mate, I'm going to say how much you mean to me as a friend. And as I may not portray that in our banter and general chit-chat sometimes, you're a man with a heart of gold and a worry bicker like a middle-aged couple over your faults and mistakes, and definitely not mine. I'm grateful to have a friend like you by my side. I've lost myself. but we both know that we have each other's backs through thick and thin. Who would have thought, by the way we got on each other's nerves back in school days, that it would have blossomed into a beautiful friendship. And the fact of gassing you up in front of all these people is just fucking beyond me. Good thing I'm not a gambling man, as I would have lost a lot of money if I would have bet against us being friends. You're my brother for life, mate, no matter where life takes us. I look forward to what holds, the future holds for you both personally and professionally. And just know that I love and appreciate you.
Although I've known you for the shortest amount of time, we've now grown apart. It feels like we've known each other a lifetime. We have so many memories of holidays, banter, sessions. And even though it feels like I've known you a lifetime, I'm not sure whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. I'm looking forward to so many more. I would like to say on behalf of our group and everyone here, we all appreciate and love you, bro. Tonight's about you. And coming from someone who doesn't have much hair on their head, let yours down.
And just quickly, while I've got everyone's attention as well, I want to say a thank you to Cole and his family for arranging such a special night. You guys really have done a crazy job, and the venue is just absolutely crazy, I love it. So yeah, you guys have really helped smash it. Massive shout out to Michaela for being such a wonderful mum, and honestly you're like the second mum to me, I don't know where Michaela is. Where's Michaela? Michaela! Also Adam as well. For possibly being taller than Cole himself. That offer of you joining our group and replacing Cole still stands, alright? It goes without saying as well what a great job Mark has done and Kate over the years to contribute to the man he is today as well. So a massive shout out to you, Mark.
One last thing, as I'm sure you guys have done with me, Luke and Waffling, we forgot to mention the 21st fact, which is that Carl is 21, and today we celebrate. So hold a glass high, and let's guard it, and have a mad one!
Listen to me. What's just a lovely thing tonight is just through not even saying anything, everybody loves Carl so much, right? Listen, me an hard fucking scaffold here. Honestly, he just absolutely is in my heart. Me and his dad grew up together and him and Kayla have made such a perfect specimen of a man. You cannot, listen to me, can we just, listen, we've got 45 seconds left on the clock. He's got such high morals, he's such a straight talking man. He gives me, if I say something out of tune, he will fucking cut me down, babe. And on the other side of the coin, it will come up and it will give me the biggest fucking cuddle you've ever seen. Once in 14 years. And his dad and Carl are so fucking, they're not the best of pals. And honestly, guys, Kay and Adam have made such a lovely human being. It's fucking truly amazing, baby! Amazing!
That is just a little word there. I think everybody said, you know, what Carl is. A lovely, lovely, lovely boy. I'm so proud of you, you know. Listen, this boy is a fucker. But you know, he's turned good. I love him to death. Love my little boy. Love, you know, all right, guys, thanks for coming, girls.
Just to wrap up on that, I want to say a massive, you want to say something?
I'm trolling this guy.
My cousin would like to say a few words.
How about Chris? So
if anyone don't know me, I'm Christine. I'm Firstly, I can't believe you say that you're here because we spoke about it, like it's your wedding. So I'm literally like, oh my god. I know how hard you've worked to make it as amazing as it looks. I know everyone here will make it a night to remember. Because I will actually cry. But you are not just my cousin, you're literally my brother, like you're my best friend and everything in between. You've been there for me through thick and thin. I honestly couldn't wish for any better. I'm gonna cry. You're one in a million. Like, I've loved you, like, I do love you, and I will love you forever.
Well done, Christy. Well done.
I think the band's gonna come on soon. I just want to say a few words. Thank you everyone for coming. Everyone looks absolutely fucking wicked.